Times Now also spoke exclusively to Army General Bipin Rawat on the occasion that marks the anniversary of the surgical strikes. General Bipin Rawat elucidated that the fact that the operations such as these are difficult as Army has to at all the time maintain an element of surprise. He also narrates the modus operandi of the strikes. Listen in.
General Bipin Rawat, we've come to the anniversary of the surgical strikes. And it was a big moment because there was the shadow of terror looming much larger perhaps than it has now. And importantly, it was perhaps different from any other operation the Indian Army has done in the recent years. How different was this surgical strike to other actions that the Indian Army has taken in the past?
This action was different because it was a very deliberate action in which the political hierarchy had been taken into confidence. And finally, to carry out the operation, the directions came from the political masters. After the terrorist act in Uri in 2016, my predecessor, General Dalbir Singh, along with the then Raksha Mantri, Mr. Manohar Parikar, had visited Uri, carried out a reconnaissance of the site where this barbaric act had been committed by terrorists supported by Pakistan. And at that time, the political hierarchy and the military felt that the terrorists and the Pakistanis have crossed the Rubicon and that some action needs to be taken. It is then that the planning process got into motion. Northern Command was then tasked to plan for this operation. They went about it meticulously. Very few people were in the know of how it will be done. The troops that were participating in this were carrying out some kind of rehearsals without knowing what the purpose of this rehearsal was. And having completed all that, the operations were conducted. The aim of the operation was to send a message to the terrorists and their supporters across the line of control that if you are going to continue with such kind of actions against our soldiers and civilians, we will not hesitate in coming to your side and destroying your camps wherever they may be. So as a part of this messaging, some of the terrorist activity that we had observed across the line of control were selected and operation carried out with utmost secrecy and stealth. I think credit goes to those people who planned for and finally executed the operation, because these are very difficult operations where you are going unannounced. There is no scope for failure. You have to succeed. And when the mission involves risk, it is only people with guts who can succeed. And let me tell you, the leadership and the soldiers who participated in this operation have proven that the Indian Army is capable of carrying out any mission, anywhere, at any time, no matter how difficult the odds are.
Sir, just to talk about the mission, first of all, you were vice chief. You were in charge of operations. So technically, you were also involved in this operation. In any case, you were involved in the planning. Tell us a little about the operations, the areas, the depth to which we went, and also the casualties incurred by the terrorists.
Well, it was spread across 15 and 16 corps. I wouldn't like to specifically go into depth because each of the objectives selected was at a different distance from the line of control. But you have to understand that the troops had to traverse long distances to reach their objective, because they had to maintain surprise. They had to ensure that do not get detected during the infiltration phase, and also then had to plan their exfiltration after having completed the task. Let me also tell you that heavy damage was caused to the Pakistani terrorists who were operating from their soil, as is evident from some of the captured video clips that we have been able to get. But then let me also tell you that when such operations are ongoing, it is very difficult to capture each and every activity, because you cannot allow surprise to be lost just because you want to record a particular activity. The primacy of the operation is stealth and the execution. Getting records of what has happened is only secondary.
Okay, we understand that. But the important point was not just causing damage, it was deterring Pakistan. And to what extent have we succeeded in that?
Well, we have succeeded in conveying our intent, and also conveying this intent to the international community, that should such actions continue from Pakistan's side, the Indian establishment will not hesitate in crossing the line of control for carrying out similar actions in the future.
And finally, this was one of its kind. As you said, this action has never been done before.
Well, the action of such a magnitude, where the political establishment is also taken into confidence, and then announcing to the whole world that we've done this, along with the magnitude and the kind of damage that we had caused to the infrastructure across, has not been done before.